In this video, we will take a look at the slide of duodenum. The slide is stained by hematoxylin eosine. That means that the nuclei of cells are violet or blue, and cytoplasm of cells is pink. The wall of duodenum consists of four layers. The first layer from lumen, the first layer is called mucosa. It's here. The mucosa is composed of three layers. First layer is lamina epithelialis, one layer of columnar epithelial cells. The next layer is lamina propria. This is loose connective tissue, which form a core of the villi. And the last layer of mucosa is formed by a thin layer of smooth muscle cells. And this layer is called lamina muscularis mucosa. The next layer, it's called submucosa. In submucosa, you can find a loose connective tissue, and the submucosa of duodenum is filled by Brunner's cells, Brunner's glands. It's a mucous gland, composed mucous gland, which filled the submucosa. In submucosa also you can find fat cells, blood vessels, and plexus submucosis masonry. The next layer is called tunica muscularis externa, which form by two layers of smooth muscle cells. First direction, it's a circular direction of smooth muscle cells. The second direction is longitudinal direction of smooth muscle cells, and between the two layers of smooth muscle cells you can find plexus myentericus auerbachii. This last layer of duodenum is very thin layer of loose connective tissue and one layer of squamous cells, which called serosa. So for the good absorption of nutrition, it's necessary to large surface. And in the duodenum, you can find three levels for increasing the absorption surface. The first level, it's formed by plicae. This is the circular fold formed by mucosa and submucosa. Here it is a plicae, one plica. The next level is formed by villi. The villi is a prominence of mucosa to the lumen. The core of villi is formed by lamina propria and lining by one layer of columnar epithelial cells. And the last level for increasing absorption surface, it's in the surface of simple columnar epithelial cells, and the apical modification is microvilli. So this is the three levels for increasing absorption surface. We will take a look at the detail of the individual part. I talk about mucosa by lining one layer of columnar epithelial cells. Here you can see one layer of nuclei of the columnar cells. This is the cytoplasm of columnar epithelial cells. So here and nucleus here. So this is the villi, and between the villi you can find intestinal glands or Lieberkühn crypts, crypts of Lieberkühn. Here it's a Lieberkühn crypt, and the crypts is lining also one layer of columnar epithelial cells, and also by goblet cells. Goblet cells, it's a unicellular endoepithelial gland produced mucus. And here, this is the pale light space between the columnar cells, and here it's a goblet cells produce mucus. So here it's again goblet cells. The nucleus, again, it's a basal part of a part and compartment of these cells, and the apical part is filled by mucus. So this is the mucosa, and here you can see the last layer of mucosa called lamina muscular mucosa. Yes, this is the thin layer of smooth muscle cells. And here it's a mucosa, and the underlining is a submucosa. Submucosa is formed by loose connective tissue and filled by mucous glands called glands of Brunner. This is the compound tubular gland produce mucus. Also in submucosa you can find fat cells, it's here, and blood vessels. You can see here the blood vessels, artery and vein. The next layer, it's a tunica mucosa, external mucosa, muscularis layer. The direction of smooth muscle cells is different. The first layer, it's a circular direction, and the second direction is a longitudinal direction of smooth muscle cells. So here it's a nuclei of the smooth muscle cells, also here. Between the two layers of muscular layer, you can find plexus mesentericus aurobachi. For example, here it's a peripheral nerve. And the last layer, it's formed by a loose connective tissue and one layer of squamous cells called serosa. So that's all to the duodenum. Thank you very much for your attention.